15 years of eternal waiting, 15 years of long nights, 15 years of endless yearning for my mundane vision to see the lights. My glorious moment has finally come to catch a glimpse of the heaven above. A human I so wish to become, as fascinating as a soaring dove. Florence is the name they call me, enticing and radiant like Aphrodite, they say. Dark red velvet curls trailing oh so freely as I swim through the sapphire waves of the pathway. From the infinite depth of the vast ocean to the surface I go, striving to find my silver lining. As a ship cruises down the water without caution, the wicked storm attacks the vessel with tenacious lightning. Humans falling, falling, and falling. Who is that I see so handsome? Humans drowning and drowning and drowning. Who is that making my heart blossom? Is this what it feels like to be in love? To want someone so much it causes you pain? To have a desire of touching him without a glove? That I stop listening to the voices inside my brain? Save him! Save him! Echoes my heart. With a swift flick of my tail, I charge to rescue him. I know deep down in my fractured self, we cannot be apart. I hold onto him tightly as I agilely glide to the brim. Here we are on the edge of the promised land. Here I wait for him to open his sealed eyes. I see an unexpected girl from his homeland walking towards him, stealing my personal sunrise. I must disappear before she notices me, hiding behind a rock that is so very near. My heart shatters as I break away from my joy, my Mary. In front of him, again I must appear. Indignant, inflamed, infuriated, I seek for Serafina, the nefarious sea witch, the one my family and I have always hated, the only one who can calm my itch. Digging into the familiar unknown, we made a perplexing deal. Out of my hips, legs had unnaturally grown, without a sense of any of this being real. The sound of my voice that cannot be heard. On the witch's hand, I see my tongue. From the inner part of my lungs, oxygen slurred, up to the human world, I sprung. With each step, the feeling of knives cut my feet, but I shall not surrender, for this is my destiny. Each step quickens my once steady heartbeat, seeing him wandering down the sand with such beauty. He sees me with my scarce tattered clothing and welcomes me to his magnificent palace. He does not recognize me. Oh, how my heart is aching. I see the girl again and all I feel is numbness. The princess has become his mistress when I was gone. What do I do now with the prince out of my reach? I must think briskly, for it will soon be dawn. I see my sisters down at the beach. The pain grows vigorously with each step I take, while I hurry down the grand palace stair. My sisters tell me, here's a knife to undo your mistake. You must kill him tonight and avoid death's glares. He is asleep, and I tiptoe near his bedside. I lift both of my hands where the dagger is placed. But the voice in my head says stop, as I tried. Instead, I stab the sharp dagger into my own waist. I'm falling, falling, and falling to the ground thump where I meet death. I'm drowning, drowning, and drowning in my very last breath. But this time, there is no one here to save me. I become a cloud of mist, slowly floating into the night sky. Is that a dazzling paradise I see? Farewell, my prince. I bid thee my last goodbye. 15 years of eternal waiting. 15 years of long nights. 15 years of endless yearning. for my mundane visions to see delights.
My glorious moment has finally come to catch a glimpse of the heaven upon a human I no longer want to become from the cruel mortal world I have withdrawn.